Can you see me clearly? What about now? Much better. Shot by Chuka here, and in today's video, we're going to be talking about lighting, how you can either make or break your videos. So without wasting much time, let's get straight into today's video. Hit it! Hello guys, how you all doing? Hope you all are doing good. Welcome back to Shot by Chuka. On this channel, we talk about everything photo and video related. So if you're new to the channel, kindly subscribe and hit the bell icon to get notified whenever I post a new video. Today, we are talking about lighting, and this is part 2 of the Stepping Up Your Game as a Content Creator series. In part 1, we talked about audio, and I gave some tips on how to get good audio in your videos. If you haven't watched that video already, pause. Click this link right now to watch it and come back to this video when you're done watching. I'll be here waiting for you.
Aguero looking for the cross. Wonderful technique to pull it in.
Che ne senti, impasseranno. Tu vela ciao, vela ciao, vela ciao, ciao, ciao.
Welcome back. Hope the video was helpful. Now back to business. Good lighting is something that can make the footage coming out of almost any camera to look good. You may think your phone camera is really bad, but it probably isn't. You may not have just exposed it to good lighting yet. I'm shooting this video right now with my mirrorless camera, the Canon M50. By the end of this video, I'm going to switch over to my smartphone, which is the Samsung Galaxy S8, to show you how it compares and to show you that you can get good results from a smartphone camera, just as long as the lighting is good. Generally, we have two types of lighting. We have the natural lighting and we have artificial lighting. Let's start with natural lighting. Natural lighting is the light given to us by God, and the main advantage of it is that it's free. Nobody charges you for it. Look for a window in your house that lets in light and see if you can make your videos in that area. Try different angles until you find the spot where the light gives you the best look. Your camera in a tripod, connect your mic to your camera or smartphone and start shooting. If you're using a mirrorless camera or DSLR, it helps to use a fast lens that allows you to take your aperture down to like f1.8, as this helps to maintain a low ISO and in turn reduce the digital noise in the footage. If you don't know what a fast lens is, don't worry, just watch this video over here. And also, if you don't know what aperture is the hole in the camera that lets in light. So the wider the hole, the more light enters into the camera, and that will lead to a brighter image or video. To know more about aperture, shutter speed, ISO, camera settings in general, watch this video over here. And I'll also leave all the links to the videos I've mentioned in this video in the description down below, so you could go check them out. So the light is coming from this window over here, and it's hitting this side of my face properly, whilst leaving some shadows over on this side, which creates a cinematic kind of look. So if the light coming in from the window is too harsh, you can make use of a transparent shower curtain to cover the window, and that's going to help to reduce the intensity of the light, make it less harsh, and make it more pleasing on camera. But in this case, the light isn't too harsh, so we would not be making use of a transparent shower curtain. But that's just something to note. But as we know, everything has a downside. So the downside of natural light is that it's not readily available. It comes during the day and it goes out at night. And even when it's available, sometimes it fluctuates. It's not a constant lighting source. It could be very bright now, and then in 10 minutes time, it could get really dark, which leads to changes in your camera's exposure, which isn't the best in any way. That doesn't mean you can't make it work though. You can make it work by planning your shots. Know the time when a nice natural soft light comes out, and immediately it comes out, pounce on it and make good use of it while it lasts. Moving on to the next type of lighting, we have artificial lighting, and as the name implies, it's light made by man. It's not free, but it's more professional. That's what I'm shooting this video with right now, but before I show you the lights, it's good to point out that there are many ways you can light your videos using artificial light. It just depends on the kind of look that you're going for. Are you going for more of a cinematic look, that is one side of your face being properly lit and the other side having a cast of shadows, also known as low-key lighting technique? Or do you just want to light your video so that both sides of your face are evenly lit up, also known as high-key lighting technique? So lighting is really subjective to the creator of the video. I personally prefer the high-key lighting technique, that is both sides of my face being evenly lit up. Let me show you how it's done. I use a 3-point lighting system. Actually, I use a 2-point lighting system, but the standard is 3-point. And the 3-point lighting system is a system that consists of a key light, a fuel light, and a backlight. Let's talk about the first, which is key light. Key light is your main light source. That is your most powerful light source. I use a softbox lighting kit setup as my key lights, and it consists of a stand, an 85-watt CFL-D light bulb, and the softbox itself. So I'm going to turn off the lights right now and start from scratch so I can show you how I build up the light system that I use. I place it at an angle of 45 degrees to myself. The closer the light is to you, the softer and nicer it will be on your face. I like my light soft, so I take my key light as close to me as possible. Want the light hard, then take it backward, because the further away the light is from you, the harder it will be. I wouldn't recommend that though. It's not just as good looking as when it's close to you, when it's soft. Also, if you will notice, this key light comes with a diffuser, which helps to reduce the harshness of the light. Without this, the light will be too harsh and I'll be feeling the intensity of the light while shooting, which will make me uncomfortable. I'll leave links in the description down below to all the lights mentioned in this video, so feel free to check them out and buy them if you want to. Moving on to the second type of light, we have fuel light, and the main aim of fuel light is to fill in the shadows on your subjects. Fill in the shadows on the other side of your face that the key light couldn't fill or cover. In my case, I use the same type of softbox lighting as my key lights for my fuel light because I want both sides of my face to be evenly lit. I place it at 45 degrees to myself, but this time at my other side, which is at my right, and I also bring it as close to me as possible to get that soft, nice looking light. Turning it off. Turning it on. Turning it off. Turning it on. Turning it off. Okay, that's enough.
What's the matter with you?
Some people prefer the look they get when using just a key light or a key light with a dimmer fuel light. They say it's more cinematic, the kind of lighting used in movies. It all boils down to personal preference. I personally prefer using both lights, but if you prefer using just one key light, then that's okay. Whatever works for you. Last but not the least, we have backlight. What this light does is that it separates the subject from the background. That is me, the subject, being separated from the background. I don't use a backlight, but if I used one, it would look like this. Notice how it creates a demarcation between myself and the background, making me pop more. There's also background light, which is used to light the background and also helps to separate the subject from the background. I don't use a background light, but if I used one, it will look like this. Back to my normal lighting setup. There are various other ways you can manipulate the lights you have to portray the kind of look you want. Let me know in the comment section down below how you light your videos. Now let's put my phone camera on the stand and see how the footage coming out from it compares to the footage coming out from my mirrorless camera. So now I'm currently recording with my smartphone, which is the Samsung Galaxy S8. Looks pretty good, right? That's as a result of good lighting. Good lighting is the key. Let's have the Canon M50 footage on screen right now, side by side, just so that you can see the differences, how it compares to both being shot at 1080p resolution. I know that the Canon M50, the colors coming from my Canon M50, which is my mirrorless camera, the colors, the skin tones will most likely be better than the one coming from my smartphone. But the smartphone still does a really good job. So all in all, this whole video was to show you that if you have a smartphone, if you're using a smartphone, you have a good device in your pocket. You have a good device that you can use to make videos. So you can make good use of it. Just ensure that your lighting is good and you have a good video coming out from it. So, capis? In the next video, I'm going to show you how to record videos with your smartphone the right way. all the necessary steps you need to take before you hit the record button on the camera app on your smartphone. So stay tuned for that by subscribing somewhere down below here and hitting the bell icon to get notified whenever I post a new video. Tap the like button if you enjoyed this video and share this video to someone you know or feel may be interested in it. Follow me on Instagram at shotbychuka to view more content from me, and we'll see you in the next one.